Can't you see this old incubator's gone bad? We're likely to lose a lot of our chicks.
Oh, those poor little things. Oh, but Aunt Em, Miss Gulch hit Toby right over the back with her rig just because she says he gets in her garden and chases her nasty dog every day.
We're busy.
But he doesn't do it every day, just once or twice a week. And besides, he can't touch your old cat anyway. And now she says she's gonna go get the sheriff.
Dorothy, please.
Uncle Henry, can't you do something?
I'm doing something right now, honey. So just keep out of our head.
Oh, all right.
Whose genius suggested we move the wagon before the wheel was on?
Well, it's a wheel. That makes sense, don't it?
Oh, sense or no sense? When I lift up the axle, you two shove it on.
Zeke, Hickory, no Miss Gulch into Toto?
I swear, they make this one wheel smaller than the other.
She tried to kill him!
Bigger, smaller, just get it on there before my arms will clean out their sockets.
Okay.
I made a statue, you know, I ain't made of iron.
Okay.
Why won't anyone listen? Don't you hear that, Toto?
Yeah! What? Look at my finger!
What am I going to do about this gulch, huh? Just because Toto chases her old cat.
Now listen, Dorothy. You are using your head on this gulch. You mean you got no brains?
Sure, I got brains.
Well, then how do you use them? You come home, don't go by this gulch's place. And Toto won't get any hurt, and you won't get no trouble. See?
Quit just standing there and clear that chunk out of the way. We got a load of lumber to haul from town before the weather turns.
Zeke, what am I going to do?
Well, for one thing, don't let that old gulch hug a buffalo. She ain't none to be afraid of. You just gotta stand up to her, that's all. A little courage, a little grit.
I'm not afraid of her.
That's what I want to hear. Walk with your chest out, your head high. Next time she squawks, stroll right up to her and spin it around. That's what I do.
Would you really?
Well, sure. Through this life, you gotta walk tall and shoot straight. Then you ain't got nothing and nobody to be afraid of.
Oh. I'll get to listen to that all the time. Huh?
One mean old woman, you were scared of her.
It weren't my place to interfere. Sorry.
you. And worst of all, you stopped Toto from getting away. I just hate you.
Don't say that, Dorothy. You make me feel terrible inside, like my heart's all tore out.
I don't care. I never want to see any of you again. Ever, ever, ever! Toto was my only friend in the world. Now I got no one to talk to and no one to play with. And I'll never see you again as long as I live. Toto! Well, what's she doing now?
Why? She's putting her hand on her heart.
Oh.
She dropped me down on the bed.
Well, you don't suppose she really could be sick, do you? Oh, I have to get home right away.
What's this? I thought you were coming with me.
Oh, no, I have to get home. Come on, Toto. Goodbye, Professor Marble, and thanks a lot.
Goodbye. Safe journey. I've got to get the horses under cover. There's a storm blowing. A lot of to speak in the vernacular of the peasantry. Poor kid. I hope she makes it home, okay?
Thank you. The munchkins are happy because you have freed them from the
That's right.
Give me a something.
I'll get you, my pretty! And you'll all go too!
person who might know would be the great and wonderful Wizard of Oz himself.
Wizard of Oz? Is he good or is he with you?
Oh, very good, but very mysterious. He lives in the Emerald City and has a long journey from here. Did you bring your broomstick with you?
No, I'm afraid I didn't.
Munchkinland. And remember, never let those ruby slippers off your feet for a second, or you'll be at the mercy of the Wicked Witch of the West.
But how do I start for the Emerald City?
It's always best to start at the beginning. And all you have to do is follow the Yellow Brick Road.
But what happens if I...
Just follow the Yellow Brick Road. Goodbye.
I can't even scare a crow.
Howdy, man!
like it. I have been scratching all my thoughts. Busy hatching if I only had a brain. I unravel every riddle for any individual in trouble or in pain.
With the thoughts scary, thinking you would be involved
in. If I only had a brain. Oh, why? I can tell you why. The ocean's near the shore. And then I'd sit and think some more. I would not be just a nothing. My head all full of stuffing. My heart all full of pain. I would dance and marry. Life would be a dignitary if I only had a brain. Oh, why? I tell you why. The ocean's near the shore. I can think of things I never loved before.
And then you'd sit and think some more.
Yes, it would be awful reason to reason out the reason of things I can't explain. Then perhaps I deserve you. If I only had a brain. If I only had a brain.
The crows would be scared to pieces.
They would?
Oh, yes.
Where is Kansas?
It's where I live. And I'm gonna get back there so badly. All the way to the Emerald City to get the Wizard of Oz to help me.
Did you see a wizard?
Mm-hmm.
Do you think if I went with you, the wizard would give me some brains?
I couldn't say. But even if he didn't, you'd be no worse off than you are now.
That's true.
But maybe better not. I thought it would mad at me and you might get into trouble.
A witch? Ha! I'm not afraid of a witch. I'm not afraid of anything. Oh, except the lion magic.
I don't blame you for that.
But if he's a box full of them and a chance of getting some brains, look, I won't be in any trouble. Because I don't need to think. And I won't try to imagine anything because I don't think. Will you take me with you?
Why, of course I will.
Hooray, we're off to see the wizard!
Yeah!
I'm gonna get him a brain!
Oh, you're not stripping off every mouth!
Oh, I'll try, really, I will!
To Oz!
Because the devil didn't see us.
green worms.
Worms? Did he say we had worms?
That's what it sounded like to me.
I'll show you how to get some apples. Yeah, you got worms and caterpillars and a better bunch of woodlice too.
Oh, how dare you! Let's give it to him, girls! Please don't pass it!
Register emotion, jealousy, devotion, and live your part.
knocking with a zipper if I only
I'll fight you with one part as on my back. to stand on one foot. I'll fight you with my eyes closed. Oh, that's it, eh? Sit up on me, eh? Why?
You're here now. Now go away and leave us alone.
Oh, scared, huh? Afraid, huh? Tell me, how long did you stay fresh in that tent? Come on, put up your dopes, you mops. You simmering junkyard. Put up your head, you lopsided bag of hay.
Yeah, it's getting personal, Lion.
Yes, why don't you get up and teach him a lesson?
Well, what's wrong with you teaching him?
Me? Well, I hardly know him. Oh, I'll get you anyway.
Oh, shame on you!
Why'd you have to go and do that for? Oh, I didn't bite him.
No, you tried to. It's got nothing to do with it. You tried to feel for the dog.
Well, you didn't have to go and hit me, did you? Is my nose bleeding?
No, of course not. I'm a fussy baby. Naturally, when you are up, you're not bigger than you are, but you're nothing but a great big cow.
You're right. I have a cow. I haven't got any courage at all. I even scare myself. Look at the circles under my eyes. I haven't slept in weeks.
Oh, hey, why don't you try County Chief?
That doesn't do any good. I'm afraid of him.
Why don't you come along with us? We're going to see the wizard to get him a heart
and him a brain.
I'm sure he can give you some courage.
Well, wouldn't you feel degraded to be seen in the company of a cowardly lion?
No, of course not.
Oh, gee, that's awfully nice of you. My life has been simply unbearable.
Well, it's all right now. The wizard will fix everything.
At least I know you'll be safe if I go with you. How's that? No self-respecting wild animal will anywhere near me. Still a lion. Poor, hard-hearted lion. To a mist, listen to me rave. Oh, the Lord revealed lion, but the Lord forgot to rave. And his tail began to coil and wave. Life is sad, but they'll be missing. But you're born to be a sissy without the Lord. But I could change my habits, evermore be still. That's if I am pulled up the dirt. I'm afraid there's no denying I'm just a dandelion. A fruit I don't deserve. But I could show my promise to be a lion. No malice in my own fleet ever learned. Why I'd be my scribe, a king down to the core.
You
could pour
the
way
you never
heard before. And then I'd move some more. I would show the dinosaurs who's came around before us, the kings. Why, with my real geezer, I would be another Caesar if I only had to go. I'd be green as a blizzard,
I'd be gentle as a lizard, I'd be clever as a wizard.
Thank you. yummy and soothing to the smell.
Thank you. not.
Want to see the wizard?
The wizard? The wizard? But nobody can see the Great Oz. And nobody's ever seen the Great Oz. Even I've never seen him.
Well, then how do you know there is one?
Because. Well, if there wasn't a wizard, then why would you be here?
Well, please, sir, I'd have to see the wizard. The
wizard is upset with me.
Prove it!
She's wearing the ruby slipper she gave her.
So she is! Well, bust my buttons! Why didn't you say that in the first place? Well, that's a horse of a different color!
What's he called a horse? Why, if he wasn't on the other side of that wall?
Oh, he's coming out!
He'll be on this side.
Welcome to the Emerald City!
Thank you!
Have you come far?
Just as long as you please.
Well, believe me, every step is worth it. Have you any idea just how wonderful this place really is?
Well, I've been trying to imagine it, but I haven't a brain.
They said I'd fall in love with it if I had a heart.
It's the one place I don't need courage because there's nothing here to scare me. Is there?
There's a garden spot where it's never too hot, it's never too cold.
Never too lonely, you're never too cold. Way never too thin or tall.
That's how we are, but they are better than we are.
dealing with it. What's it say? What's it say?
Oh. Surrender, Dorothy.
Oh. Dorothy? Who's Dorothy?
Perhaps the wizard will tell us.
Thank you.
We'll get you to see the wizard somehow.
We certainly will.
And he was so good to me, and I never appreciated it. Running away and hurting her feelings. Professor Marvel said that she would be sick, and it's all my fault. I'll never forgive myself.
Thank you.
castle.
There's no yellow brick road to follow now.
There's no road at all to the land of the Winkies.
Winkies? What's Winkies?
Once they were humans, very much like yourselves. And then the Wicked Witch made them her slaves. I hope the same thing doesn't happen to you. Just keep going to the west, where the sun sets.
Is that the best way to find the Wicked Witch?
Oh, you won't have to find her, Dorothy. She'll find you. Good luck.
Sometimes I'm glad I don't have a brain. I have the wits to be scared.
And I haven't the heart to fail. I haven't said goodbye to the visit. Oh, no. Now, how did you deserve Dorothy now?
Well, I could stay here. That'd be my way of doing it.
Shame on you. You're more of a coward than I thought.
Well, that's easy for you to say. You're made of straw, and you're made of tin, and I'm only weak flesh.
Very weak.
Yes.
Verging on flabby.
That's all right, Brian. You can stay here if you like.
I'd like. But if you really need me, I suppose I'll tell you all.
That's more like it, stout fellow. Come on, Dorothy.
Best foot forward.
Decisions, decisions.
Come on, Wyatt.
I'm coming up. Step up the hill again. Ready.
You shall be there to scoop up the little brat and the little brute
turn back if I were you.
Fun.
No! No!
Spooks. That's ridiculous. That's just silly.
Don't you believe in spooks?
No. Only fools believe in spooks. No, stop!
You did it!
Are you alright? My jumps around my knees.
I think I see a shadow that's causing it to worry.
I don't have a brain, but I think I have a worry.
I haven't got a heart, but I feel a palpitation.
I've been out on the forest, I don't like the situation.
Are you gonna stand by like those little horrors?
I'm glad to warm now. I think I lost my roar.
It's a hostess!
It's a hostess!
It's a whatsis!
It's a whatsis!
Who's there?
Who's there?
Who's where?
Beware!
The trees, but it do what the jitterbug.
Well, what happened to you?
Oh, they took my lantern and threw it over there. And then they took my pride and then threw it over there.
Oh, Scarecrow, that's you all over.
Time to put yourself together.
I would. I can't reach my legs. Oh,
and then we'll go find Dorothy.
There's Toto!
Oh, don't you see? He's come to take us to Dorothy!
Well,
tail holds out. What's that? What's that? It's the castle of the Wicked Witch. Dorothy's in there? Oh, I hate to think of her in there. We've got to get her out.
Well, don't you start crying now. We haven't got the oil can with us. And you've been squeaking as it is.
Eeny, meeny, miny,
She's dead. You've killed her.
Didn't mean to kill her, really. I didn't. It just said she was going to set him on fire.
Hell to Dorothy. The Wicked Witch is dead. You are now our queen.
That's very kind of you, but I have to get back to Kansas. The witch's room. May we have it?
Please, take it.
Now we can go back to the Emerald City and tell them the Wicked Witch is dead.
No more brains than you have. But They have one thing you haven't got, a diploma. Therefore, by virtue of the authority vested in me by Universitatis Comitiatum e Pluribus Unum, I hereby confer upon you the honorary degree of Ph.D.
Ph.D.?
Yes, that's a Doctor of Thingology.
Isosceles triangle is equal to the third side. Rapture! I have a brain! How can I ever thank you enough?
Well, you can't. As for you, my fine friend, you are under the unfortunate delusion that simply because you run away from danger, you have no courage. You are confusing courage with wisdom. Back where I come from, we have men who are called heroes, and once a year, they take their fortitude out of the mothballs and parade it down the main street of the city, and with no more courage than you have. But they have one thing you haven't got, a medal. Therefore, for meritorious conduct, extraordinary valor, conspicuous bravery against wicked witches, I hereby award you the Triple Cross. You are now a member of the Legion of Courage.
Oh, chief officer of such auspicious.
As for you, my galvanized friend, you want a heart. You don't know how lucky you are not to have one. Hearts will never be practical until they can be made unbreakable.
But I still want one.
Back where I come from, we have men who do nothing all day but good deeds. They're called filler. Good deed doers. Their hearts are no bigger than yours, but they have one thing you haven't got, a testimonial. Therefore, in consideration of your kindness, I take pleasure at this time in presenting you with a small token of our esteem and affection. And remember my sentimental friend, a heart is not measured by how much you love, by how much you were loved by others.
Oh, listen! Oh, looking hard! Listen! Read my bell! Read my bell!
Awarded for courage!
Edit the truth!
Well, they're all wonderful.
Wait! What about Dorothy?
Yes, what about Dorothy?
Yeah, so go for that.
But I'm afraid you forced me into a cataclysmic decision. The only way to get Dorothy back to Kansas is for me to take her there myself.
Oh, will you? Could you? Are you a clever enough wizard to manage it?
Child, you cut me to the quick. I'm an old Kansas man myself. Premier balloonist par excellence to the Miracle Wonderland Carnival Company. Until one day, while performing spectacular feats of the stratospheric skill never before attempted by civilized man, the balloon failed to return to the fair.
That's terrible.
Frightened?
You are talking to a man who is laughed in the face of death. Ha ha! Sneered at doom. Chuckled at catastrophe.
I was petrified.
And then the wind changed. And then the balloon floated down into the heart of this noble city, where I was instantly acclaimed Oz, first wizard deluxe. The months being fresh, being luxury. Times being what they were, I accepted the job, retaining the balloon against the advent of quick getaway. And it is in that balloon, my dear Dorothy, that you and I will return to the land of E. Pluribus Unum. Skip this way.
Thank you.
of Oz. I, your wizard per ardua ad alta, am about to embark on a hazardous and yet technically unexplainable journey into the outer stratosphere. To confer, converse, and otherwise hobnob with my brother wizards. And I hereby decree that until that time, if any, that I return, the Scarecrow, by virtue of its highly superior brains, shall rule in my stead. Assisted by the Tin Man, by virtue of his magnificent heart. And the Lion, by virtue of his courage. Obey them as you would me. Thank you, my friend. And now I think it is time we cast off. Climb aboard, dear Dorothy, climb aboard.
Climb aboard, Missy, while the wind's in your favor.
Yes. Say goodbye, Toto. I'm here now.
I just dropped by because I heard the little girl got caught in the... Oh, oh, she seems fine now.
She did take a bump on the head. For a minute there, we thought she was going to leave us.
Oh, Mark.
I did leave you alone. It's just the trouble. I was trying to get back to you for days and days.
Oh, there, there. Now you sit quiet. Now you just have to have to read.
Can't forget your old pal, huh?
Me, Hickory. You couldn't forget my face, could you?
But it wasn't a dream. It was a place. And you and you and you were there, and you were there, but you were alone.
Well, it's not your personal.
Well, we dream a lot of silly things.
But anyway, Toto, we're home. Home. And this is my house. And you're all here, and I'm never going to leave you again because I love you so much.